Hello, I'm Andy, and I'm going to read to you a program called Tarot Monthly Horoscope for Zodiac Signs, and this is for the month of October 2017, and it is for you coming from Leo. So let me shuffle my Kabbalistic tarot cards quickly, and the first card that I'm going to pull will have to do predicting your first 15 days in October. And let's start with the area of romance. Your first 15 days are really a big bundle of problems. They show difficulties in keeping the romance together if you have an existing romance. And if you find a romance in the first 15 days, it's going to come with a lot of complications, past issues, whether yours or whether the romance partner are also seen, leading to arguments and differences. So think carefully about the new romance coming your way in the first 15 days. Don't give your heart away too quickly. Have a wait and see period. Study the nature of that person, and you will see that unless you are careful, you're getting yourself into problems in the first 15 days with a new romance. Ongoing romances are going to be under pressure a lot, and there's going to be a lot of dissatisfaction and unhappiness. And all this can come from your side, it can come from the romance partner's side. Either way, it's a very unhappy first 15 days. You have to improve it by definitely not wanting to show your temper, you coming from Leo. Definitely not being arrogant or dominating. Now, regarding your marriage, the situation is also very difficult. And the situation shows that financial issues and unexpected new problems, trouble from past related issues, all so many things are all bundled up here. They're all intertwined with this card. I like to use Kabbalistic tarot cards because they show zodiac signs and planetary signs. And all these are showing, and the financial issue is contributing to a lot of unhappiness as well. So there you are in your marriage area, so many difficulties coming your way. So you have to, you are the one who is listening to me. You have to tell yourself that you need to conduct yourself well. Do not push blame, otherwise it's going to come back to you like an avalanche as well. So be kind, be appreciative, be loving. Even in this most difficult of times, you have to keep the bonding together. Now, looking at this first 15 days in areas of family, don't allow your siblings or your parents to interfere with your problems, because they can only make it worse. So all areas in your problems for you. Let me go to your job or your career area, and bad news can really come regarding your situation of your job. You can be blamed, you can be unhappy in so many areas. Past problems are also coming against you. And so you need to be a person who has to concentrate on your job and not allow situations to overcome you where mistakes will be made which have become very serious in your job area. If you are in business, try to be very cautious that finances can run out. So the last thing you want to do is be adventurous looking for new businesses. What you have in hand is already a whole handful of problems. So concentrate what you have and try to do better that way. It's only 15 days, tell yourself, and whether in areas of romance or marriage or business or whether in job, you can survive. So keep your first 15 days in a survival mode and don't expose yourself to risk. Well, that's a problem. Now I'm going to pull the next card, and this is for your last 15 days of October. And your last 15 days of October for you coming from Leo are almost just as bad, except that there's on this card showing that a planetary sign is coming to help you. So you may have about 30% of help in the last 15 days where your romance is concerned. And if you find a romance in the last 15 days, tell yourself that the situation, it's not as bad as the first 15 days, but still not good enough for you to dive into the romance. So have a wait and see period. Study the nature of your newfound romance. Go slow, because some disappointments are still there. They have got to do with something of your past or something of the past of that new romance person. Regarding your marriage area, this card shows that marriage difficulties are there, conflict comes very, very quickly. But there's also opportunities for bonding. As long as you take the soft approach, and as long as you are appreciative of what your marriage partner wants to help you doing, or your romance partner as well. And so in areas of love and romance and marriage, take the soft approach and you'll be able to improve your last 15 days. But there are also signs on this card showing that the problems of the first 15 days seem to be ongoing in the last 15 days. So take the soft approach. Don't go in hammer and tongs. Try to be showing appreciation to problems. All right? Now, if you have a job, the job is going to attract plenty of difficulties and conflict with superiors. And if you have a business, it says don't take risk because you won't be able to keep going. So in both career and business, a new opportunity can be found. But the trouble is that this new opportunity hasn't got enough strength. And so I'd rather you not make drastic changes in your job or in business. What you have in hand, after the first 15 days of problem, these certain planets are moving into the second half of the month and they are creating problems as well. So whatever you have in hand, a job or in business, put your energy there to keep it afloat and to help yourself. Definitely you're getting some more help in the last 15 days in areas of business and job, but not enough to be able to want to start into something new. So take it easy where that is concerned, okay? I'm going to pull up both these cards and talk to you about your lucky dates for you coming from Leo. And looking at the planetary signs here, I'm going to choose the 7th, the 16th and the 25th for you. Now, these are going to be very good dates, morning, noon, afternoon and night time, for you to find solutions on the 7th, 16th and the 25th, whether in areas of romance, marriage, job, finances, business, whatever. And so bookmark these dates, communicate, go all out in the area that you want to focus on in the month of October, and put your heart and soul on this 7th, 16th, 25th to make contacts or to ask favors or to communicate and make your move. So you have some opportunities there on the 7th, 16th and the 25th. Now I'm going to talk to you about your health. And based on these cards, my worry is firstly your bowels and your bladder. So the bowels and the bladder areas seem to be, because of the planetary signs here, and these planets will attack in the month of October, your bowels and your bladder. So if you have some issue there, well, go and see a doctor about it. You will also have some danger of appendicitis. So if you have a sharp pain on your right-hand side, the lower abdomen, you tell yourself it could be appendicitis. Because this one planet can bring unexpected problems, so my mind has gone to appendicitis issues. It also could mean some danger of accidents, so don't be too rash in whatever you do. Well, I'm already Skyping, and the Skyping is going to cost $50 for a 90-minute Skype session. And this Skype session will be based on your date of birth and time of birth, and me looking at your palms, me face reading you while we Skype, and me using Kabbalistic Tarot if you want that in the 90 minutes as well. So go to Skype, go to Facebook, send me an email, make a date. I want to get your next 5 or 6 years. That's what the 90 minutes is going to produce. A lot of in-depth about your next 5 or 6 years in all areas of your life so that you can be on top in your next 5 or 6 years and produce the best for yourself in all areas of your life. I look forward to hearing from you. Until then, thank you and goodbye.